Hi everyone, it's Friday, March 5th. I'm Jim Hummel with your KATC News Brief. 11 more animals are being relocated in an alleged puppy mill case in Sunset. St. Landry Parish President Jesse Bellard gave an update today. He says a private veterinarian determined last week that all the animals should be taken from the home. The sheriff's office says the case is being handled by animal control, and several nonprofits have also been helping to take the animals to be evaluated.
We got to make sure that we take care of our animals, make sure that we take care of them in the right manner. These puppy mills, for the most part, don't do that. I went to the one last week, and when you stack dogs on top of dogs, you have 3 and 4 and 5 layers of cages, and these animals, you try to touch them, they back away from you because they haven't been touched by a human being in a very long time.
One person is dead after a crash on Ambassador Caffrey and Gilbo Road in Lafayette. Police say at around 1 a.m., the driver of a dump truck hit 2 vehicles and a utility pole, which did cause some power outages. The driver of the truck was killed. A second driver was injured. The road was closed for about 11 hours. Some encouraging news in today's coronavirus headlines. The number of cases statewide continues to drop. The Department of Health reports a little more than 500 new cases and 30 additional deaths. The numbers have been on a steady decline since a January 4th peak of almost 6,000 cases. Across Acadiana, there are 81 new cases and 6 additional deaths. In St. Landry Parish, 9th and 10th graders on a hybrid schedule will be heading back to school Wednesday. All students in the parish will now be back in the classroom for daily in-person learning. Also, students wanting to leave or join the virtual academy should contact an administrator by next Friday. In Lafayette, several pastors are now vaccinated against COVID-19, and they are encouraging their communities to do the same. LCG's Chief of Minority Affairs, Carlos Harvin, organized that event over at the Parish Health Unit. The pastors made the decision to protect themselves and to encourage residents to get the vaccine. Dr. Tina Stefanski with LDH hopes these leaders will be an inspiration to their congregations.
What we're really battling is misinformation. And again, I think when individuals see their trusted members of their religious community taking the action to be vaccinated, I think that really helps to dispel some of those myths.
Let's get a check of the weekend forecast with Chief Meteorologist Rob Perillo. Hey, Rob.
Hey, Jim. Scattered showers moving across the area for this Friday evening. Those showers will be moving out somewhere between 11 o'clock and about midnight tonight, maybe an hour or two after that. Then after that, breezy and cooler air filtering back into the region. Maybe some clouds first thing Saturday morning, but overall it's going to be a very nice day. Temperatures start out near 50. They'll finish off in the mid-60s with breezy northeasterly winds for the most part. And as we move ahead through Sunday, another good looking day, chilly at night, Saturday night, Sunday night. But look at this, 70s back in the forecast, well into the 70s toward the end of next week. And it could be potentially a stormy back end of the following weekend. We'll have more on that in the days to come. But in the near term, good looking weather for the weekend. That's it for news and weather. We'll see you again a little bit later on. Thanks for watching.